द फोर्थ बाई गोज टू द लास्ट टीम ऑफ द अपर हाफ, द फिफ्थ बाई गोज टू द सेकेंड लास्ट टीम ऑफ द लोअर हाफ, द सेम सिक्वेंस विल बी फॉलोड बाई गिविंग द नेक्स्ट बाई योर बाईस। आई थिंक इट हैड मेक यू क्लियर। वंस अगेन लेट अस सी, द फर्स्ट बाई गोज टू द लास्ट टीम ऑफ द लोअर हाफ, द सेकेंड बाई गोज टू द फर्स्ट टीम ऑफ द अपर हाफ, द थर्ड बाई गोज टू द फर्स्ट टीम ऑफ द लोअर हाफ, द फोर्थ बाई गोज टू द लास्ट टीम ऑफ द अपर हाफ, द फिफ्थ बाई गोज टू द सेकेंड लास्ट टीम ऑफ द लोअर हाफ एंड सो ऑन। द सेम सिक्वेंस विल बी फॉलोड फॉर नेक्स्ट बाई और बाईस। नाउ वी विल लर्न हाउ नंबर्स ऑफ राउंड्स आर कैलकुलेटेड इन नॉकआउट टूर्नामेंट। When the number of participating team is power of 2, that is 2, 4, 8, 16, 32 and so on, then number of rounds will be number of 2s making up n. For an example, number of team is 8, n equals to 8, number of round that will be 2 into 2 into 2, 2 into 2, 4, 4 into 2, 8. How many 2s are there? 3, 2, 1, 2, 3. So how many rounds are there? 3 rounds. Let us take another example. If the number of team is 16, n equals to 16, number of round will be 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, 2 into 2, 4, 4 into 2, 8, 8 into 2, 16. How many 2s are there? 4 2s are there. So number of round is 4. When n is not the power of 2, then how rounds will be calculated? Then number of rounds will be based on the next highest power of 2. For an example, if number of team is 9, n equals to 9, the next highest power of 2 is 16. 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 8 to the 16. Next highest power of 2, 9 is 16. How many 2s are there? 4 2s. So number of round is 4. Let us take another example. If number of team is 11, n equals to 11, the next highest power of 2 is again 16, which is 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. How many 2s are there? 4 2s are there. So number of round is 4. Let us take one more example. If the number of team is 7, n equals to 7, the next highest power of 2 is 2 into 2 into 2. 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8. The next number, the next power which is more than 7 is 8. The next power which is more than 11 is 16. The next power which is more than 9 is 16. So we have to calculate according that only. The next highest power of 2 is 8, which is 2 into 2 into 2. 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8. How many 2s are there? 3 2s are there. So number of round is 3. I think it had make you clear how rounds are calculated in knockout tournament. Now we will study number of team each quarter. For tournaments with a small number of teams, the teams can be divided into upper and lower half only. If the number of team is 11, 7, 12, 13, 14, if the number of teams, participating team is small, then only teams can be divided in upper and lower halves only. When the number of team is more, if the, for example, 30 teams, 40 teams, 23 teams, 24 teams, then teams are divided into upper and lower halves, which are then further broken into two parts. Therefore, the upper half will have two quarters, first and second, and lower half will have two quarters as well, third and fourth. In order to determine the number of team in each quarter, the total number of team is first divided by 4. The total number of team, if the number of team is 30, then we will first divide 30 divided by 4. If the remainder is 0, then the 4 quarter will have equal number of team. If the remainder, by dividing the team with 4, if remainder comes 0, then equal teams will be divided. If the remainder comes 1, the first quarter will have one extra team. It will make you clear if we go through example only. If the remainder is 2, the first and third quarter will have an extra team each. If the remainder is 3, the first, second and third quarter will have extra team each. It means if the remainder is 0, then equally team will be divided. If the remainder is 1, then first quarter will have one extra team. If the remainder is 2, then first and third quarter will have one extra team. If the remainder is 3, then first, second and third quarter will have one extra team each. Let us take an example that will make you clear. The following table will explain how distribution of teams in quarter works. Distribution of team in quarters. Suppose let us take the number of teams is 28. First we will understand 28. 28 we have to divide it by 4. Dividing 28 by 4 we will get 28 divided by 4 we will get 7. So the remainder comes, that is 0. So we will divide the team in each quarter equally, 7 7 7 7. Next, if the number of participating team is 29, then we will divide 29 by 4. The remainder that will come is 1. So if the remainder is 1, then the first quarter will get one extra team and the rest other three quarter will have the same. The first quarter will gain one extra team. Let us take another example. If the number of team is 30, then the remainder comes, that is 2. So if the remainder is 2, the first and third quarter will have one extra team each and the rest will have same. Let us take another example, 31. The remainder that will come is 3. If the remainder is 3, then the first, second and third quarter will have one extra team each and the last one will remain as it is. So let us see, we have added one in each quarter, first, second and third. And so on. If the number of team is 32, the remainder will be 0. So each team will get equal. If the remainder is 1, then the first quarter will get one extra team. If the remainder is 2, then first and third quarter will get one extra team. If the remainder is 3, then first, second and third quarter will get one extra team each. It will make you more clear if we practice it through an example. So in the next class, we will go through some examples. Then after, we will move towards procedure to draw fixture on league basis. Thank you. Stay safe and blessed.